While most people are familiar with the recurring catastrophic earthquakes in California and Alaska, there is a lesser known but potentially more dangerous seismic zone that stretches across the middle of the United States, the New Madrid Seismic Zone. Experts consider this region to be the most seismically active in the country, despite it being poorly understood. Now scientists are concerned that the New Madrid Fault may soon experience a major seismic activity, which could result in landslides, tsunamis, and loss of lives in several parts of Missouri, Arkansas, and Tennessee. Here's why these areas will suffer from a series of devastating earthquakes in the near future, and what will happen when they hit. Join us as we unravel the threat posed by the New Madrid Fault in 2024, and why it could hit the middle of the U.S. In the early hours of April 18, 1906, the city of San Francisco was rudely awakened by a powerful tremor. Earthquakes were not rare in this seismic region, but this one was different. It carried an incredible force that surpassed anything they had ever felt before. In just 20 seconds, before they could fully comprehend what was happening, the ground beneath them shook once more. This time, it was the main event. The San Andreas Fault ruptured, stretching an astonishing 300 miles. The epicenter was believed to be somewhere in the vast expanse of San Francisco Bay. For a terrifying 45 seconds, the ground rebelled against the people of San Francisco. It must have felt like an eternity for those caught in its merciless grip. Although the Richter scale had not yet been invented, experts estimate that the magnitude of this earthquake reached a staggering 7.9, making it one of the most dangerous ever to hit the continental United States. In the early 1900s, earthquake-resistant architecture was still in its infancy. Consequently, when this massive quake struck, entire blocks of buildings crumbled, burying unsuspecting occupants who had been peacefully asleep just moments before. Streets were torn apart, sinkholes appeared, and buildings along the coastline sank into the ground as if swallowed by an insatiable abyss. The very soil quivered and turned into treacherous quicksand. It took a remarkable 19 minutes for seismographs in New York City to detect the seismic waves as they traveled across the vast expanse of the North American continent. When the shaking finally stopped and the dust settled, the true extent of the devastation became painfully apparent. Approximately 80 to 90% of San Francisco lay in ruins, destroyed by the merciless earthquake and the subsequent fires that engulfed the city. About 400,000 people, 75% of the city's population, were left homeless. Over 60,000 buildings were reduced to smoldering heaps across a 20-square-mile wasteland. The city's once proud landmarks and bustling factories became mere memories consumed by the unforgiving inferno. In terms of financial loss, the property damage was valued at a staggering $400 million in 1906, which would amount to a mind-boggling $11.5 billion in today's currency. Now, imagine an earthquake far more disastrous than that, but this time in the middle of the United States. The New Madrid Seismic Zone is now the center of attention as scientists and residents in the region have reported unsettling and strange activities, heightening the sense of urgency and concern. As we delve deeper into these alarming developments and their potential impact on the nation and the world, we invite you to join us on this gripping journey. But before we dive into the details, let's first understand why experts are concerned about the New Madrid Seismic Zone. The New Madrid Seismic Zone often gets overshadowed by its more famous earthquake-prone counterparts in California, the Pacific Northwest, and Alaska. Still, this seismic region, stretching across several states including Missouri, Arkansas, Tennessee, and Kentucky, is one of the most dangerous in the United States. It has the potential to disrupt the lives of millions of Americans. To understand the origins of the New Madrid Seismic Zone, we have to go back about 750 million years ago to the Precambrian era. During that time, the supercontinent Rodinia began to break apart, leading to the formation of a rift valley. However, this rift failed to split the continent entirely, resulting in a weak zone in the Earth's crust. This ancient rift, now buried deep beneath layers of sediment from the Mississippi River, is the reason why this region is surprisingly hilly amidst an otherwise flat topography. The Mississippi River, the lifeblood of this region, meanders through the heart of the New Madrid seismic zone, creating a broad alluvial plain that serves as a crucial artery for commerce, agriculture, and transportation. The river's floodplain, characterized by rich, fertile soils, has historically supported extensive agricultural development, with vast fields of cotton, soybeans, and other crops stretching across the landscape. Adjacent to the river, the terrain rises gently into the Ozark Plateau to the west and the Appalachian Mountains to the east, offering a stark contrast to the flat floodplains. These uplands, with their rugged hills and forests, showcase the variety of habitats and ecosystems present in the area. The Ozarks, known for their captivating landscapes with numerous caves, springs, and sinkholes, contribute unique geological features that add to the region's topography. The seismic zone itself, defined by its underground faults, has subtly influenced the surface geography. Earthquakes have altered the course of rivers, including the Mississippi River, created new water bodies, and reshaped the land through liquefaction and landslides. These geological events have left behind a landscape that bears the scars of its history. What makes this seismic activity in the New Madrid seismic zone intriguing is that it is characterized by interplate earthquakes, which occur within the interior of a tectonic plate rather than at the boundaries, where such events are more common. This mystery baffles scientists as these earthquakes occur far from the edge of the North American plate. Unlike other seismic zones, the New Madrid zone is not defined by a single fault line, but rather by a network of faults that crisscross the region. These faults are hidden beneath the Earth's surface, making them difficult to study and fully understand. It is for this reason that few people have ever really expected a major earthquake to hit this region, despite its history of causing significant damage. Today, the New Madrid seismic zone remains a significant concern for geologists and emergency planners alike. Although it hasn't caused any issues recently, history has shown just how destructive it can be. Speaking of history, we will explore the history of earthquakes in the New Madrid seismic zone, and then important predictions made about the coming earthquake. Hey guys, just a moment before we continue. Be sure to join the Insane Curiosity channel. Click on the bell, you'll help us to make products of even higher quality. Now back to the video. History of earthquakes in this region. The New Madrid area was a relatively new addition to the United States when it experienced a series of major earthquakes. Before that, it went through a series of changes in ownership between the French and Spanish, with a brief return to French control before finally becoming part of the United States. In 1789, the town of New Madrid was established under Spanish rule, with American settlers who had pledged their loyalty to Spain. This move was a strategic one by Spain to prevent the expansion of American influence into their territory. During the Spanish period, the town was named New Madrid in honor of the Spanish minister who facilitated the relocation of the settlers. The goal was to create a buffer of American settlers who remained loyal to Spain, acting as a deterrent to the United States' encroachment on Spanish-held Louisiana. Additionally, the Spanish wanted to maintain control over the important trade routes along and around the powerful Mississippi River. Despite facing challenges such as flooding and limited food supplies, the Spanish government offered generous land grants, which encouraged a significant influx of American settlers to move westward. By the early 19th century, the population had grown substantially, establishing New Madrid as a crucial settlement in the region. It became the busiest port between St. Louis and the Gulf Coast, serving as a vital trade hub and a prominent stop for numerous boats navigating the Mississippi. However, the era of Spanish control gradually came to an end in 1800, when Spain discreetly returned Louisiana to France. Napoleon, who was focused on conflicts in Europe and losing interest in an American empire, decided to sell the vast territory to the United States in 1803 for $15 million. This historic deal, known as the Louisiana Purchase, officially made New Madrid a part of the United States in 1804, much to the delight of its predominantly American residents. Unfortunately, the joy of becoming part of the United States was short-lived for the people of New Madrid. Just 8 years later, a series of devastating earthquakes struck the area. These earthquakes not only caused havoc in New Madrid, but also led to the destruction in other emerging settlements along the Mississippi River. But that's not all. In 1811 and 1812, this area experienced a series of major earthquakes that shaped what we have come to know about the region. These earthquakes, ranging from magnitude 7.0 to 7.5, were felt over a massive region of about 1 million square miles. It was the largest series of earthquakes ever recorded in North America. Reports from that time describe some truly awe-inspiring scenes. Picture ground waves rolling across the land, rivers flowing backward, huge fissures opening up in the earth, and intense shaking that brought down chimneys and trees. The town of New Madrid, Missouri, located near the epicenter, suffered extensive damage, and the landscape of the region was permanently altered. New lakes formed, and sections of the mighty Mississippi River changed their course. Interestingly, aftershocks continued to be felt in the region until 1817, a full 5 years after the initial event. In the years following the 1811-1812 earthquakes, the region experienced some other significant seismic events, although none of them matched the magnitude of those early 1800 quakes. The largest earthquakes since then occurred on January 4, 1843 and October 31, 1895, with estimated magnitudes of 6.0 and 6.6 respectively. The 1895 event, centered near Charleston, Missouri, wreaked havoc on the town, causing damage to almost all buildings. It even created sand volcanoes and cracks on the Cairo Rail Bridge. The impact was felt as far away as St. Louis, Missouri, Memphis, Tennessee, Gadsden, Alabama, and Evansville, Indiana. While not directly within the New Madrid seismic zone, a 5.4 magnitude quake near Dale, Illinois on November 9, 1968, highlighted the surprising seismic activity of the entire region. The earthquake damaged the Civic Building in Henderson, Kentucky, and people as far away as Boston, Massachusetts reportedly felt their buildings swaying due to the tremors. Over the years, scientists and historians have been working hard to understand the long-term activity of the New Madrid seismic zone. Their research has shown that large earthquakes have occurred in this area roughly every 500 years over the last few thousand years. However, when it comes to predicting future large earthquakes in the region, scientists have varying opinions. It's an ongoing topic of discussion and investigation. When should we expect the next earthquake? In the New Madrid seismic zone, small earthquakes occur every year, but they are typically too faint for humans to notice and can only be detected by sensitive instruments. Scientists currently estimate that there is a 10% chance of a large earthquake, ranging from magnitude 7.0 to 8.0, happening within the next 50 years. Predicting the timing of moderate to large earthquakes in the New Madrid seismic zone is extremely challenging due to their infrequent occurrence. To gain a better understanding of the fault system, scientists are employing various research methods in addition to studying seismic waves. Although scientists cannot predict when an earthquake will strike, they can provide a probabilistic seismic hazard analysis for an area. This analysis involves examining the geological materials present in the seismic zone, studying the stress buildup in the area, and analyzing the historical record. By considering these factors, experts can calculate the probability of an earthquake exceeding a certain magnitude. Paleoseismology techniques are also used by scientists to identify evidence of large prehistoric earthquakes that have been preserved in geological materials, such as soil and rock. By determining the approximate locations, ages, and magnitudes of these past earthquakes, researchers can calculate the average recurrence interval over a long period. Currently, paleoseismologists have identified evidence of at least three large earthquakes, magnitude 7.0 or greater, occurring within the past 2,000 years. This evidence, combined with data from written records spanning approximately 200 years and instrumental recordings spanning around 100 years, helps estimate the frequency of earthquake recurrence or average behavior. Addressing the situation requires taking steps to enhance earthquake preparedness and resilience, especially since many structures in the central United States are not designed to withstand the forces of a major quake, unlike those on the West Coast. Older buildings, including residential structures, schools, and hospitals, could sustain severe damage or even collapse in the event of a significant seismic event. Although modern buildings are generally more resilient, they can still be affected by shaking if they lack the latest earthquake-resistant technologies, which is still the case for many structures. In addition to the immediate structural damage, critical infrastructure such as bridges, roads, pipelines, and power lines could be severely impacted. This disruption would have far-reaching consequences, including the disruption of transportation and communication networks. For instance, Interstate 55, which connects New Orleans to Chicago, would likely become unusable for an extended period. Furthermore, the Mississippi River, a crucial corridor for travel and trade, could also be rendered unusable or filled with debris, posing significant challenges for navigation. Such disruptions would not only hamper emergency response efforts, but also have a cascading effect on supply chains, potentially leading to shortages of food, water, and medical supplies. The Mississippi River plays a vital role in the transportation of imports, exports, and domestic freight, carrying over 500 million tons of goods in 2019. All of this activity would grind to a halt in the wake of a major earthquake. The New Madrid Seismic Zone is currently home to a little over 2.1 million people. The largest population center in the region is the Memphis, Tennessee metro area, with 1.3 million residents. Other notable population centers include Jonesboro, Arkansas, with 135,000 people, and Cape Girardeau, with 100,000 people. Additionally, there are 45 smaller towns and cities in the area with a population greater than 1,000. It's important to note that the impact of a major earthquake would extend beyond the New Madrid seismic zone, affecting areas such as St. Louis, Missouri, Nashville, Tennessee, and Evansville, Indiana. This means that a significant number of people outside the immediate seismic zone could also experience the impact of such an event. In your opinion, what possible earthquake should the U.S. be most concerned about? Do you think the government is doing enough work to address these earthquakes when they finally come? Feel free to leave your answers in the comments below. If you like this video, then you should check out this one on a cataclysmic earthquake that has gathered widespread attention. Thanks for watching.